Hi everyone. So in this next portion of our class, we are going to do little flowers with lines. So step one, I'm going to apply 2 coats of my gel polish. So coat one, we're gonna cure that for 30 seconds in our LED light. And I've already gone ahead and loaded my palette here again. So this time I'm gonna use a little bit of white. I'm using titanium white in gel paint. You can use what you have. Any type of gel paint is easy enough to do. You need to make sure that you have a brush that has a nice fine tip. Very, very, very important when you are doing any type of line work. So I'm gonna go ahead and give this another coat. A little too much product on my brush there. And we're gonna go ahead and cure that for 30 seconds in our LED light. And our most important step that we're going to do after this is apply matte top coat or wipe off the dispersion layer. Either one is going to work beautifully. So I'm just getting my matte top coat ready. And we are going to paint. Again, you want to apply it nice and even. So the reason that we apply matte top coat is because if we don't, our brush is going to slide all over the place. And we definitely don't want that to happen. So I'm going to go ahead and start loading my brush. So I'm going to roll it in here. And actually, you're going to be able to see much better in this segment how far up the ferrule that you're gonna go. So you're gonna go, you can go a little bit higher, but again, you never wanna get paint down into the ferrule here. It causes your bristles to come out. It just makes a big mess. So always keep your bristles, or always keep your product at about the halfway mark. So that's about a decent amount. So I'm going to wipe off the dispersion layer from my matte top coat because it's still shiny and it's not going to paint nicely. Give that a couple seconds to dry. And so we're going to do like a horseshoe design. So I'm going to start in the middle. Again, nice short strokes. And I'm gonna pull this down. I need a little bit more product on my paint or on my brush. So just a nice little horseshoey design. Pull it down from this side, down here, and then I'm going to create another little horseshoe design, and we're just going to pull that down further. But I'm going to go over this one here a couple times. There we go, that's better. So you can always go over your petals or your lines multiple times. You can always start off too thin and then add to it later. It's easier to add more than it is to take it off. So that's one little petal. Now we're going to do another one. I'm going to move it over a little bit more. Starting in the middle. And we're pulling it down. And if you're not happy with how it looks, again, you can always wipe it off. That is the beauty of working with gel. And we're going to do one more petal over here. The problem that I'm having is I didn't put enough paint on my brush, so I have to keep reloading it. So we're just going to go over some of our lines. And now here we're going to do like a half. And then for our center, we're just going to do dots. So when you're doing dots, that's the one time where you can have a little ball of paint at the end of your brush. You can use a dotting tool, but when you're doing flowers, I like to have the dots look not so precise and perfect. I find it just looks so much better if you do it that way. And I think I'm going to do a couple little leaves as well. So for our leaves, we're just going to start here. And we're just going to do a couple little leaves. That's one. I'm going to put another one underneath. And I always like to do them in odd numbers. You never just want two. You can have one or maybe three, but you never want even numbers. I always go with odd numbers. And then we're going to do our stem. I'm going to put one over here. One stem, and then we're just going to put a few little dots over here, and we're going to put a few over here. And there we have it, a nice simple little design. So I'm going to go ahead and cure that. Then I'm going to clean off my brush. You can clean off your brush one of two ways. You can dip it in clear gel and wipe it off on a paper towel. You can leave a little bit of product in there, or you can use alcohol. Clear gel will keep your bristles together a little bit more, and it'll keep the longevity of your brush. If you are constantly using alcohol, it will dry out your bristles much quicker than anything. So there's our little flower design, and we're gonna go ahead and put a top coat on that. I don't think we need to add anything else to it. So when you're doing lines, flowers, any of that, keeping things simple is always my favorite thing to do. Our next little lesson, we're going to go into doing some swirls. Everyone is terrified to do swirls because, oh, it looks so difficult and it's so much more intricate. But once you learn how to do a basic swirl, you can do so much with it. So that will be our next little mini lesson. And again, I'm going to do a printout of everything that we talked about in our classes. So there's our finished little flower design. So off to the next lesson.